We are set, ready to rock for this.
All right, guys, here we go.
And these guys on your screen,
do this.
Well.
EOG killer.
Game, speaking of the game,
okay.
Let's get right to it.
Looks like he might be a passer with his receivers that he has. All right, here we go. Help.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line.
See here. Started off slow.
First carry for Matt Ford.
Oh, I can't. That sucks. God dang it, I didn't see him because he was off screen. Dang it.
Well, usually you don't think of the cornerback coming in for a no-gain play, but that's what we had there. Nice tackle.
And how about the range, too? Coming from the outside part of the play, moving his way into the inside and making that play happen. No gain for the offense.
Oh, he freaking drops it, really.
Jordan Reed was the intended
target. Man.
And that'll make it third down.
Can't drop it.
He might not provide.
Can't
the
drop the ball, sir.
Very often, but he's pretty
freaking
reliable.
Heck, man.
He's an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Flush to his right.
Ah, wow. Darn it.
Mike Evans, the one he was looking for.
God dang it. That sucks.
Now the former Gamecock, Spencer Lanning, on to punt it away. And Sanders now to return. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Falcon football as they take possession.
Up against Brett Favre.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive.
Oh!
First pass is incomplete.
God dang it. Almost thought that could be picked.
The intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around
come on.
Him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
Dang it.
A gain of 32 that time.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
He'll drop to throw. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Okay. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time, and that'll bring up second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And over the middle to the tight end, Bennett. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
Come on. Stop him.
They'll look to throw again. Try to
get
him, and it's intercepted.
Nice.
And he's able to
there
get it
go.
Back to right around the 27. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be set.
Ah, darn it, man. Come on, I need some type of blocking here.
Back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity, nothing big happened, but then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
He's got a man wide open.
Nice. There we go.
And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. So Herman Moore, his first grab of the game, and back in his day, he shattered all the Lions' receiving records.
And he did it with a number of different quarterbacks. He was the target for defenses to adjust to. And I guess the best way to put it is...
All right, I might have to give up here.
...and be just as successful.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
One of the toughest things for an offensive lineman to learn is the ability to get in space and hit people who are moving targets.
God dang it.
They're not easy ones to hit because they know how to move.
Can't get anybody freaking going here.
Did on that play, a nice play for the defense. Oh,
man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground.
God dang it, man! I can't freaking get anybody open!
And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that
they come on.
Moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down.
Come on!
And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Now it's the Chiefs' all-time leading rusher, Jamal Charles, on the carry. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number 2. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out. Charles, the lone setback. And now they'll try the end around. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
A reverse is never called just to get 1 or 2 yards. It's often called to get a big, big play. The defense was having none of it on that one. They sniffed it out and stuffed it.
And the offense needs 7 out of this play on 3rd down. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots.
Yeah, is that what I just said? Really? My God, this neck sucks. I just keep forgetting to turn it off. That is so stupid. I hate the
Connect. 7 yards remain now on 3rd down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw.
Oh, almost picked.
As he was throwing it, and the ball drops incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion, and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And the Falcons are out to a 3.
All right, let me get moving on offense.
So after slogging through a scoreless first quarter, we have action on the scoreboard. A field goal makes it 3-0.
Well, with these two offenses, we weren't going to stay 0-0 forever, were we? I'm not sure that this opens the floodgates, but I doubt that's the last score we're going to see.
And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before.
Dang it. Man.
Picked off by Sean Smith.
I hate doing that. I hate doing that.
At the 20-yard line. They'll come out throwing here on first down.
Now,
this is intercepted.
I got saved there.
Sanders, the former Falcon, with it. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. Now last time was a pretty one play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do? You got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And Reed with it over the middle. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And it'll give the Patriots a 1st down.
And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right
up. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay right. The same.
I have to do something to get the ball moving.
That I don't like this rule. Where the offensive player fumbles the ball, goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college. You know what he used to name the sideline? Sammy. Sammy sideline, and use him well.
It's caught by Mike Evans. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. And we've arrived at the two-minute warning here in half number one. The first down throw here for Rivers. And it's go down. He sacked back at the 24. Jurrell Casey. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Now a second down throw for Rivers. It's caught right side by Daniels. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him 14 on the play. And that'll lead here to a third down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller,
because
that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football.
Fourth inches.
You do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Probably regret this.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. They come up in an offset eye.
Wow.
Escaping this time, it's go down. They got
what did I say?
Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back.
I should have shotgun. I should have expected it. Freaking blitz.
Got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try to add to your lead.
Oh, nice.
Time here in this half, it's intercepted.
There.
God. Back into the end zone. The Patriot defense has a touchdown. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone,
great.
That means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it.
Stupid.
When
the other always goes off.
And picked up a touchdown.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory.
Hank really have a decent defense who can get me out of situations.
Right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Oh my God!
For the fourth time today.
Nice.
And it's picked off. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. The Patriots' offense now—they work their way back onto the field.
Now, if I could just get my freaking offense going.
Fourth and goal. Rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive.
A simple tip of the cap, a nod of the head to the defense. Congratulations, you got us last time. But you didn't hold us the whole time. We got down to position. We were able to be in position to score. Let's go ahead and attack again. Continue to have that kind of confidence. Not worry about the one play that didn't allow him to get into the end zone.
And this time they'll be trying to get it in. We'll see what they do. He was looking for Alfred Morris that time. That'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since been.
Man, why am I having such an issue right now? God.
Was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defense. defensive guys have been talking about is we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they missed a golden opportunity.
On third down, Rivers.
God dang it.
Incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
Oh, the nice.
Defender took some liberties there with a late hit, roughing the passer.
The league has done a great job of defining what is a late hit. An illegal contact on a quarterback, the defenders really have to get in line.
Rivers, his pass caught at the four. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here. And it's caught. It's a touchdown.
There we go.
And we'll have to check the flag, but I think this one's going to stand. Catanzaro now for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-point
game. Frustrating first half.
Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away.
Fortunately, the guy keeps coming turnovers. Counteracts my freaking two turnovers.
And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll throw now on the final play, finding time. And bringing it in right side here, Beckham. We have hit.
Gets to Beckham almost every time.
Quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something
come on
important than it actually is. Right?
Nice.
Create more hype than what is there. But this is a real, I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. And this is incomplete. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. On third down, he'll drop to throw.
Can't get through.
He's going to sling this deep downfield. And
there
he
go.
Complete. He can't hang on.
Oh, my. Are you kidding me? Really? That was probably the most sloppiest win I've ever had. My God, that was a sloppy win.